is that?
Well, I was friends with very close friends with a woman photographer, filmmaker, Barbara Rubin. And Barbara, one day, Andy was not at the factory. Barbara was came to the factory, and she saw me, of course, and she said, "I want to introduce you to the Velvet Underground." That day, they were performing in a cafe in Greenwich Village, and so I went. And Barbara knew that I liked to dance, so I went down with Barbara to the Cafe Bazaar, and she introduced me to the group. There were a lot of young teenagers sitting at little tables around. There was no stage; it was all on one floor, so there was no proscenium, and. The problem the Velvets had was that no one would get up to dance to their music. So, and I was a regular 3 years earlier. I was a regular 4 years earlier. I was a regular on the Alan Freed show, television in New York. Which is a version of, I should say, that Dick Clark imitated Alan Freed. Anyway, that's what it was. I was a regular on the Alan Freed show, dancing every day after school. In high school, my last year in high school, I would go down to the TV studio, and I loved dancing, okay? So it was very natural for me. So, and I had the whip with me that day when I went to visit the Velvets. I had bought this whip not to use for dancing. I bought it as a fashion accoutrement, okay? At a show, it was called Sammy's Umbrellas. On the upper West Side, he sold umbrellas and he sold whips. It was a weirdest combination. And so I bought myself a really nice whip, and I had it with me when I went down to visit the Velvets. And the Velvets started playing, and Barbara said, "Go up and because there was no proscenium, I felt I was intruding on while they're playing music." And they said, "No, they're not going to. They want go up and dance. They're not going to pay any attention to you." So I got up there on the front and I started dancing. And I somehow at some point pulled out the whip very spontaneously and started dancing with the whip in front of the Velvets while they're playing. And people started getting up off the table and started dancing for the first time. They felt like they had a dead audience. And people started dancing. And let me tell you, at the end of the session, I didn't stay for the whole thing, but during intermission, Lou and John came up to me and said, "Oh, please come back." Now, they were very excited by this. And of course, we did come back two or three nights later with Andy in tow. And that's when Andy met the Velvets for the first time. And that's where it was decided that Andy made the factory open to them to rehearse, to do, you know, rehearsals for their music, you know.